Welcome to the Safety Products Workshop. In this particular video, we're going to concentrate on the PFU210E and the filter set that corresponds to this particular unit and the choices that are offered to you, the user. PFU stands for Powered Filter Unit, and the 210 refers to 210 litres per minute maximum airspeed from the unit itself. We can see here that we have a two-stage motor, and we also have a filter state indicator and a battery state indicator as well. One long press and we switching the unit on. Short press will jump between speed number one and speed number two. Typically we're looking there between 160 and 210 litres of air per minute. And you can see here the filter state indicator. The filter starts to become blocked, this filter state indicator will become orange. And then if the filter becomes blocked to a state where it really needs to be changed, this will turn to red and you'll get some vibration from the filtering device itself. So you get an audio alarm and you also get a vibration, a physical alarm that you can feel on your body because you're wearing this device obviously around your waist. The battery state indicator does exactly what it says. You know, it's identifying the battery state, the charge state of the battery. And again, if the battery level drops to a position where it really needs to be recharged and you should be leaving the work area and recharging the battery, you'll get some form of alarm. Now let's talk about the filters themselves, because that's what we're focusing specifically on in this particular video. For the majority of applications, most users simply need to be using the particle filter with the pre-filter. That accommodates the majority of welding work environments. But as we've said in previous videos, in order to understand what type of risks you're presented with within your welding environment, you really need to have an independent air quality measurement done on the premises. They'll take those measurements at different times of the day, they'll take those measurements in different areas of the workplace, and then they'll give you some level of report, and that will define exactly what type of contaminants are found within the work environment itself. But that said, the majority of users out there are perfectly well protected with these high grade particle PRSL filters and also the pre-filter that goes with it. Always when you're talking about filters, you use a pre-filter and a particle filter. You cannot, for example, filter particulate if you use only a gas filter on its own. And let me introduce the gas filter to you. Gas filters are very specific to certain welding environments, and when you get that advice on your particular welding environment and that you're defining exactly what type of materials you're welding with, what type of contaminants are in the atmosphere, the independent advisor, those that really know this subject, will be able to tell you the concentrations of any gas substances that are in the atmosphere for which a gas filter should or could be used. Let me just show you how the gas filter is fitting to the PFU210E. Very simple and very quick, and I'll open up this belt. Now, the gas filter itself also has an excellent feature which extends the work life or the runtime of the battery system and extends the life of the filter itself. And Kempe call this smart sense technology. When you actually fit the gas filter to the PFU210E, the unit knows that the gas filter is fitted, and that restricts the maximum airspeed to 160 litres a minute. Adequate enough air coming into the breathing zone, nice and comfortable, nice and cooling, safe breathing air. But because we restrict the selection of the upper speed, it just extends the life of the gas filter. Because these gas filters are obviously a lot more expensive than the standard particle filter set that you would otherwise be using. But if you need a gas filter, you obviously need a gas filter set. So that expense is something that has to be borne for adequate protection within the workplace itself. So you always use pre-filter and particle filter. We've just mentioned that, but you have to use that combined filter set also with the gas filter as well. So that actually would look like this if it's outside of the unit itself. You have the pre-filter here, then you have the particle filter, and then behind that you have the gas filter. So gas filters do not filter particulate, they only filter gas substances, and the gas substances are identified in all the product support material that comes with the gas filter itself. And actually there are standards which define what an A1, B1, E1 gas filter for the welding environment has to filter. There's a standard it has to meet, it's certified, it's tested, so you can be absolutely assured that this filter will give you exactly what you expect it to deliver. So how does it fit to the unit? The orange button is always fitting to what you will see as the right-hand side of the unit. And simply, you just need to make sure that the gas filter is linked on. You push it as far as possible in this direction and then click it into position. Nice and simple. Over the top goes the pre-filter and then the particle filter. And that filter set then sits over the top of the unit and clicks into place. And there we have it. Gas filter is now fitted to the unit, obviously adds some size and some weight, and as I said earlier, some cost. But if you need it, you need it. But you're protected perfectly in terms of filtering particulate and also filtering gases that can be found in the welding environment. One thing you need to be absolutely sure about is the level of oxygen content within the workspace that you're working in. And if the oxygen level were to drop below 17%, you definitely should not be working in that environment. So again, you really need to know and have professional, independent air quality advice, and also carry out your work risk assessments in a proper way. So let me just show you, now the gas filter is fitted, if we select the on-off button and we select speed number one, you can see that when we try to select speed number two, that's not possible now because we have the smart sense technology on the gas filter, which is extending the life of the gas filter, and importantly, because you've got lower run speeds, is extending the life of the battery itself. When you're using gas filters, by the way, just reach down here, it's always a good idea to fit the heavy duty battery to the PFU 210E. This will extend the runtime beyond that of the standard battery about twofold. And worth mentioning, but if weight is what's important, then you have the choice of the smaller battery also. You just need to be charging that battery up more frequently. Battery charge times are typically 2 hours and 3.5 hours for the standard battery and the heavy duty battery. But that's it for fitting the gas filter and combined filter sets with particle filters. So thank you very much for watching. If you'd like more information, check out www.kempe.com. You'll find lots of information online, and also you can also download our welding safety product catalog. So we have a new version online right now. So thank you very much for watching and look forward to seeing you next time. So cheerio, bye-bye.